Get the upper hand on your competition with SCUF controllers. Use code OGXRACE to get 5% off your entire order. Yo guys, what's up? It's X-Rays. Welcome back to another video here on the channel. Hopefully you guys do go out and enjoy this. We're going to be talking about some more leaks here in Call of Duty World War II. Specifically, we're going to be talking about headquarters, quartermaster, contract, armory, prestige, and armory credits, because it looks like you're going to be doing a whole lot more with this game in terms of armory credit, which is going to be a spendable kind of currency in the game, similar to keys maybe, but better than keys in that you can actually use them for more than just supply drops. As it turns out, in this Call of Duty World War II, not only will you be able to use them for that, but you'll also be able to use them for other items, and we'll discuss that. But hopefully you guys do go on and enjoy the video. If you guys do, drop a like on the video. If that's why, it is appreciated. And if you are brand new to the channel, I do a ton of Call of Duty World War II news, info, leaks, and more, along with live content. So make sure you guys do subscribe so you don't miss those videos. But anyways, let's jump into the information. It's all pretty sick. Headquarters, as we know, is going to be a pretty big place. It's going to take up to 48 people. It's going to be the maximum amount allowed per headquarters. It's all interactive. It's going to be a proximity-based mic system, so you can talk to people who are near you, and you're not going to hear all 48 people at the same time, so that's very cool. But we didn't know more than that. We knew there was going to be like a raid-type thing where like a bunch of ships or airplanes coming in and attacking. We knew that there was going to be stuff like being able to use score streaks, being able to have a 1v1 pit, making sure you can open supply drops in front of people. There was a ton of stuff on that. But we got even more information, and it's all actually pretty exciting. So I'm gonna read through this. If you guys wanna read this, all this information is on Reddit. I'm gonna go ahead and link it down below. I'm gonna cover some of this because some of this actually gets me pretty excited with the possibility of there being a system where you can just straight up delete stuff. No need to just delete duplicates, but actually delete stuff in your armory for credits. So this just expands the amount of content that we as YouTubers can make. So that to me is very exciting. But anyways, let's read through it. You can meet requisition officer. You can pick up credits at payroll. Acquire supply drops from the quartermaster. So the quartermaster is coming back, similar to Infinite Warfare, but this is obviously their version of it, not some robot. You can open your supply drops. You can shoot 5 targets at the firing range. And you can also inspect your weapon. Now the quartermaster, the description given in the code was, the quartermaster is a one-stop shop for gear, weapons, and other types of loot. Get supplied and get back in the fight. Now there is also the gunsmith. This actually has me the most intrigued because we all know that there was a form of currency in Call of Duty. For instance, it was crypto keys. And then more recently, we had Infinite Warfare, which had salvage. And then you also had your keys. So you had salvage, which you could use to build up variants and stuff like that and purchase it. And you could also do the same thing in Modern Warfare Remastered, but they were called, I believe, just parts. But this time, it says, maker of fine weapons of warfare, weapon forge, no weapon available to be forged. So basically, this is, you know, stuff that was in the beta code. Test, customize, and equip your score streaks. So you can try out your score streaks and customize them, which is interesting, customizing your score streaks. But you can do them and try them out with the gunsmith. Now, it also says you can browse your score streak loot, which I'm wondering, is there going to be variants similar to what they did in Infinite Warfare? We'll definitely see, but maybe it's just cosmetic variants, so maybe your plane can have your logo on it. That would actually be pretty sick when you're watching the UAVs kind of flying up top, if you actually had your logo on it, or if a custom emblem you made or something like that. That'd be pretty cool, actually, but custom loot for score streaks seems pretty interesting. And then the actual code said, inventory, get crafted weapon content, and then also inventory, player has parts for weapons. So you can bring in parts or use parts to build the weapons or variants, or I don't know, but we'll definitely see. But that's interesting, because if there are no stat-changing variants, then this system is kind of weird. Maybe you need them for loot specifically, or maybe there's actual weapons you can get in the game. I don't know. So that's actually pretty interesting. Now let's talk about the armory, because MWR has an armory. You also have an armory of sorts in Call of Duty Infinite Warfare when you go to the quartermaster. But now you have a ton more stuff here. So it says armory. Armory confirm, redeem all duplicates. So you can redeem your duplicates similar to in Black Ops 3, similar to in Infinite Warfare, where they straight up just deleted it from it and gave you salvage. But then if you keep reading, it says S2 armory credit icon. So we already talked about that. Armory credit inventory, convert item to armory credit. This to me is probably the most interesting one, because in Black Ops 3 you could get rid of duplicates, but that was pretty much it. It was just an option, and we already saw there is an option on there where it says redeem all duplicates. And in Infinite Warfare you had it where it was just straight up deleting them for you, but in this one it says inventory, convert item to armory credit. Now this is interesting because we haven't had an option to go straight into your inventory and just delete stuff from the armory. Like, we haven't had that in Black Ops 3. We didn't have that in Infinite Warfare because it was automatic. So what could this mean? Is it gonna be like Sledgehammer Games' last game, Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, where you could go into your armory, delete anything that you wanted, and maybe you can get credit back for that, and you can use that to go in and, you know, craft whatever you want or buy whatever you want. So this is all very, very interesting, because now in the armory, you have the option to delete stuff. And this could be bringing back so many new series, like the series I used to have on the channel, like the Russian Roulette, or where I could do wagers with people where you can delete your weapon. This seems like the feature that is coming back, and I'm actually very, very excited for that. Now, apart from that, this is actually also very interesting, but there's also something called a heroic challenge, and you have to purchase this with your armory credit. So you can purchase contracts. Maybe it's similar to in Black Ops 1 where you purchase contracts, you complete it, you get back a ton more credits. I don't know, but it's still pretty interesting that they have a heroic challenge, and there is also a heroic level supply drop. So we'll definitely see about that. And then after that, it says armory drops. We have launcher, LMG, melee, pistol, rifle, shotgun, SMG, and sniper. And then order rewards, we have 50 armory credit, 30 armory credit, and 70 armory credit reward. So I believe that basically you can complete these challenges, these heroic challenges that you need to buy with your credit, and then it'll give you back credits for completing that challenge, you know, within a certain amount of time, I would assume, similar to in Black Ops 1. Now, this is actually pretty cool, or very interesting. I don't know what this means, because we already know we got armory credit, but now we got something else called supply keys. Now, it says in the mail station, which is a different area where you can check bulletins and stuff like that, plus you also pick up rewards from there as well. Sledgehammer Games gives out free stuff every once in a while in the mail station, and it says collect your wages reward from HQ and other messages. Check back frequently for cool rewards and surprises direct from Sledgehammer Games. Return once a day to pick up your payment of supply keys. Is it different from armory credit? I don't know. Come back every 4 hours to collect your supply keys. So you come back once a day, you get a bonus. Come back every 4 hours, you get another bonus. Yes, I'm up for this. Give me more, Sledgehammer. And then the last one says retrieve your payroll from the mail station. I wonder what that means. Payroll? Are they giving us more stuff? God damn, they're giving us a ton of content. It mentioned a little bit about prestiging, but it's kind of boring. This, I guess, is the interesting part. You get to keep all of your progress for weapons, challenges, and your customization. You just lose the weapon until you unlock it again. So that is actually pretty sick, but that's pretty much it for prestiging. You can prestige in front of everyone, and then you also get a reward for doing that. So pretty cool. Now, the next thing is daily orders. Now, it says in the description, report to Major Marcus Howard on a daily basis to receive your orders and get the highest amount of reward. Complete and redeem 6 daily orders within 24 hours to receive a unique reward. I wonder what that unique reward is. But some of the challenges, there's a ton of them on here. Like, goddamn, there's a ton. And make sure you guys check out the link down below if you guys want to see all of them. But there's a ton of them. Like, you have to win a 1v1, command, receive command, shout out wins, theater watch, kills, headshots. There's a whole bunch of them. Whole bunch of challenges. The next one is weekly orders. And it says complete 3 weekly orders within 7 days to receive a unique reward. Again, pretty freaking interesting. We got a lot of them. Range sequence, score streak calls, flat gun event, fire kills, war party win. I mean, there's a ton of stuff on here that you can complete as well for that. We got special orders as well, but no info on that. And we also have contracts, which says ante up and get the job done, clocks ticking. I don't know if this is one that you actually buy similar to the heroic challenge. I don't know. But there's actually contracts again, and maybe these are just daily, but then we also do have the daily orders and weekly. So is daily and weekly different from the contracts? I don't know, but still very, very interesting for that. And anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching the video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy it. If you did, drop a like on the video. It does apply. It is appreciated. And if you are brand new, if you want to see more content like this, a lot more Call of Duty news as well as live content, then make sure you guys do subscribe and you turn on notifications by hitting that little bell icon down below. But anyways, hopefully you guys did enjoy the video. Follow me on Twitter, best place to talk, and check out my gaming channel and second channel, both linked down below. I'll see you guys next time. I'm out. Peace. But anyways, guys, that is all the info I want to cover here for... And also check out...